The present document discusses the root cause for the wildlife food emergence in China, the exotic foods, the wet markets, and the wildlife trafficking, and also how we can save ourselves from the different viruses.
Consumption of wildlife in China was confined to the southern part of the country before Mao Zedong brought about a change in the social and economic fabric of the country. It has been estimated that between 18 to 45 million deaths occurred due to starvation, disease and violence during this period. To combat the shortage of food, people started killing and consuming wild animals. In this process, many species went extinct. Mao launched the most brutal and moth-killing sparrows campaigning in 1958. He believed that sparrows consumed grain that belonged to the people, so they deserved death. In the year 1960, the Chinese Communist government had total control on food production and farming. The government failed to feed the entire country. The poor farmers with little or no resources had to turn to catch wild animals such as snakes, turtles, bats, and others. This practice solved the hunger problem on a large scale. Hence, the regime allowed the wildlife wet markets to thrive. The wildlife farming got structure in 1988 after the Chinese government passed the Wildlife Protection Law, which enabled people to use wildlife animals as resources. Wildlife wet markets became an industry, and any industry focuses on expansion. The variety of wild animals in wet markets rapidly increased. Animals such as bears, peacocks, rabbits, and tigers were part of the menu. Many endangered species were also poached to supply at a higher rate to wealthy clients illegally. Wherever there is a market, there will always be a MAC channel to provide rare products. Peter Lee from Houston mentions that designation of wildlife as a natural and resources and legalized brought several changes in the farming of Chinese economy.
The wet markets are center for virus breeding. We can also call them manufacturing centers for atomic bombs. Dr. Leong He Nam, doctor from Singapore, mentions that the wet markets we are breeding virus. Possibilities are more for mutations and pass the same to humans and then person to person.
After the SARS outbreak, the National Forestry and Grassland Administration strengthened oversight of the wildlife business, licensing the legal farming and sale of 54 wild animals, including civets, turtle, and crocodiles, and approved breeding of endangered species, including bears, tigers, and pangolins, for environmental and conservation purposes.
Snake farming is one of the biggest business growing faster rate in China. Today, the wildlife stock in China is worth about $73 billion and employed 1 million people in the profession.
Live markets of Wuhan is a home to over 100 different animals getting slaughtered and sold in front of the customers, and hence called wet markets. In Wuhan wet market, numerous wild animals, including live wolf pups, salamanders, crocodiles, scorpions, rats, squirrels, foxes, civets, and turtles. You name the animal, you will get the flesh of that animal in the Wuhan market. In the wet markets, the animals are kept in cages which are stacked one above the other. Thus, a scene where a cage with bats of snakes on the top and cages containing turtles, civets, ducks, porcupine, and pangolins stocked below them are common in these markets. The extra and fluids from the species kept at the top will fall on those creatures kept below and entire stock act as a natural mixing bowl that provides the virus an opportunity to jump from one organism to another. While handling the meat or the living animal, human beings contract the virus. Inside the human body, the virus undergoes a mutation and can subsequently develop the capacity to transmit from one person to another person. The Chinese food habits and culture is unique and different from other cultures. Majority of them like to eat exotic foods. Some of them like to eat living snakes, which you can observe here. They also like to eat snake meat, whether fried or raw, along with the beer. They are interested to have snake eggs, which are available from the local market. For some of them, the delicious food is living cobras heart, which you can observe here. Living cobras heart was taken and eaten. Now let us look into the exotic food menu of the Chinese people. They like the bat soup, raw or fried roots, insects of various kinds, scorpions, kidney of different animals, brain of a monkey, roasted rats, living larvae, grilled birds, seahorse with birds, bugs of various kind. The monkey and mink brain eating is a unique culture for them. The delicious food for them is monkey's flesh and monkey's brain, which you can observe here. For some of them, it is a luxurious food. It is common among the Chinese eating hatching eggs of various kinds. The menu of street food is exhaustive. One can have both vegetarian and non-vegetarian. In non-vegetarian food items, you will get more than 100 varieties of flesh foods made with different kinds of flies, birds, varieties of fishes, reptiles, and animals. Soups made with varieties of flesh is a delicious food for them. Xi Jinping, the president of China, promoting traditional Chinese medicine. Now the business is worth about $130 billion. On October 2019, the president said to the state-run media China that traditional Chinese medicine is a treasure of Chinese civilization. Chinese use all kinds of wildlife for preparing the traditional medicine. Most important them are tiger. All the parts of the tiger is used for the medicine. Rhino horns, horns of deer, skin of elephants, foot of bear. They have well established the stores, which stores all varieties of Chinese traditional medicines. Snakes have been considered medicinal for thousands of years in China. People there swallow snake pills and drink snake wine made from snake based ingredients because they believe that it helps to cure the spinal disease or reduce the damage to one's liver when taken before drinking alcohol. A single gram of snake venom can bring $450 to $750 to the Chinese farmer. The spread of zoonotic diseases is exacerbated by wildlife trafficking, wildlife markets, habitat destruction, and climate change. These threats drive humans and animals into closer proximity. Live animal markets are a major source of new viruses, including ones that cause zoonotic diseases, which are transmitted between species. COVID-19 likely originated in a live animal market selling wildlife. Wildlife are being poached and hunted, often to near extinction, for exotic food, fake medicine, and pets. A permanent ban on markets trading in wildlife would protect endangered species and humans. There is an urgent need in combating trafficking of wild animals within countries and across borders. Now there is a need to change dangerous wildlife consumption behavior, especially in the urban areas.
to save yourself from the infectious diseases and coronaviruses, you must avoid eating the food from Chinese restaurants or from the Chinese food festival or from the street festivals. It is too dangerous. The live animals transmit the viruses. Eating wildlife food is nothing but exposing yourself to various kinds of viruses. Dr. Liang Ho Nam also says that wildlife markets are the breeding centers for the viruses, and one day the right mutation will happen when the receptor fits nicely well into the humans. Disease ecologist Thomas Gilfsey with the primatologist Jenny Goddell rightly points out that I am not at all surprised about the coronavirus outbreak. He says, the majority of the pathogens are still to be discovered. We are at the very tip of the iceberg. Man is also held responsible to create new virus under the new environment. The forced situation made the monkey to eat the rat, the snake to eat bat, and both the snake and monkey was eaten by human being. This leads to the creation of a new virus by the human being by the way of mutations. Some of the scientists claim that pangolins, bats, and snakes are held responsible for the virus. Knowing well about the impact of the virus on human beings, the man still continues to eat the virus-contaminated food. Consideration of traditional Chinese medicine by the World Health Organization further aggravated the growth of wildlife trafficking and wildlife farming the entire world. Using wildlife for traditional medicine should be banned. Illegal trafficking of wildlife should be banned, and strict rules should be implemented not to do illegal business on wildlife within the state and outside the state or international trading. Wildlife food providing and exotic food providing restaurants and hotels should be closed permanently, and strict orders should be given by the state government, and vigilance should be developed on these restaurants about the food they are serving. Now you think of yourself, how to save yourself from the viruses in future. That is why you try to avoid wildlife food, exotic food, street food, and also going to the restaurants of Chinese food.